that you have begun entering monthly surveillance data, we want to provide you with a three-part video series that will cover when to report a C. difficile LABID event, common data reporting errors, and an introduction to NHSN data analysis. In this video, we will focus on NHSN surveillance definitions for reporting a C. difficile LABID event. Next, a C. difficile positive laboratory assay is defined as an unformed loose stool that tests positive for C. difficile toxin A and/or B, includes molecular assays, PCR, and/or toxin assays, or a toxin-producing C. difficile organism detected in an unformed loose stool sample by culture or other laboratory means. Please note, it is very important that you verify with your reporting laboratory that they have a policy in place which allows only unformed or loose stool specimens to be tested for C. difficile. This will ensure that all of your C. difficile specimens meet the CDC recommended testing guidelines. Let's discuss two scenarios for reporting a C. difficile LABID event. Your facility sends a resident's loose or unformed stool specimen to the laboratory, and the test comes back positive for C. difficile. The resident has not had a positive C. difficile test within the previous 14 days in your facility. This will be reported as a C. difficile LABID event. A resident left your facility to go to the emergency department or another outpatient healthcare setting, such as a physician office. The healthcare provider suspects C. difficile for this resident and has an appropriate stool sample sent to the laboratory for C. difficile testing. The resident was not admitted to this outside healthcare setting and returns to your facility within 2 calendar days. The stool specimen comes back positive for C. difficile, therefore you will report this C. difficile LABID event into NHSN. As a reminder, you will not create a C. difficile LABID event using laboratory results from other healthcare facilities before a resident was admitted to your facility or during a resident's admission in another facility. And you will not create a C. difficile LABID event if the resident had a positive C. difficile test within the previous 14 days of another positive test. This is considered a duplicate. To avoid reporting duplicate events, keep a log of positive C. difficile laboratory results. In the next video, we will cover common data reporting errors into NHSN.